ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
సో నౌ లెట్ us డిస్కస్ టూ మోర్ అప్లికేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ బాయిల్స్ లా. టూ మోర్ అప్లికేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ బాయిల్స్ లా హియర్. సో దట్ ఈస్ క్విల్ ట్యూబ్ అపరేటస్. Quill tube. So before going to this, what is meant by net force? Net force, when the body is at rest. When the body is at rest. So for example, this is the some mass attached from the string, attached from the rigid end. Now the body is at rest. That means the body does not moving upwards, the body does not moving downwards. Body does not move upwards, does not move downwards. So it is at rest. That means upward is T, downward is mg. So that's why T is equals to mg. So that means upward force is equals to downward force, then only the body must be at rest. So that means the body is said to be in equilibrium. So equilibrium means, let us say, if the body is on the surface, horizontal surface, on the table, let us say, that is at rest. When the body is at rest, let us say downward force is mg, but upward force is normal force. If upward force is normal force, then the body is at rest. That means upward force must be equal to downward force, then the body is at rest. So that is. So based on why we are discussing about this means, based on this Quill tube, we have these concepts. When the body is at rest means net force acts on the body is zero, then the body is at rest. Net force acts on the body is zero, then the body is said to be in equilibrium. Equilibrium means if the body is at rest, then the body continues to be at rest. If the body is in motion, it continues to be in motion, whatever are the applied forces. If the net force acts on the body is zero, then the body is said to be in equilibrium. So here Quill tube. So what is the Quill tube means? Let us say it is a long cylindrical column. Long cylindrical column having this mouth like this. One end is opened. One end is opened. Other end is closed like this. So in this, at the middle, so this is the mercury column. This mercury column, the some amount of mercury is trapped here. So an amount of mercury like this. Like this. That is the mercury column. And it is the closed end, and certain amount of air is trapped. Certain amount of air is trapped here. Certain amount of air is trapped. And this is mercury column. So here, and this is open end. At the open end, the pressure must be atmospheric pressure. At the open end, the pressure must be atmospheric pressure. At the closed end, the pressure must be more when compared to this one. How the pressure varies in the closed end, that's we have to discuss how the pressure varies in the closed end. So here, let us say here, L1 be the length of the liquid column here, length of the air column that is trapped, length of the air column. So let us say here the pressure is P0 and here the pressure is P1. Here the pressure acting downwards, here the pressure acting upwards. It is the closed one. And here it is the open. Open one means, let us say, atmospheric pressure. It is a closed one. Maybe the pressure is more or less depending on the given situation. So depending on the given conditions. First one, here it is the pressure P1, here it is the pressure P0. But we know, here we know, pressure is equals to force per unit area That means force is equals to pressure into area. Force equals to pressure into area. So when this mercury column remains at rest, when this liquid column, the weight of this liquid column acting downwards, weight of the mercury column Mg acting downwards, always weight must be acts downwards. Weight of the liquid column acts downwards. Here the pressure also acting downwards, but this pressure acting upwards. So that means if it is at rest, then what we can write? Total upward force is equals to total downward force. Total upward force is equals to total downward force. What is the upward force due to pressure P1? So let us say upward force, let us say F1, downward force Mg plus F2, it is downwards. F1 can be written as P1 into A, that is Mg plus it is P0 A. Force can be written as pressure into area. Here the pressure is P0, here the pressure is P1, that is why P1A is equals to Mg plus P0A. Then we can write P1A is equals to mass can be written as volume into density plus P0A. P1A is equals to volume can be written as area into height, H is capital H let us say, rho g plus P0A. Area cancels on both sides. So therefore, P1 is equals to P0 plus H rho g. P1 is equals to P0 plus H, let us say small h, it is height of the, where small h is, let us say it is H. Small h is height of mercury column. Mercury column. So that's for P0, P1 can be written as, P0 can be written as capital H rho g. So here it is small h rho g. So P1 is equals to capital H plus small h into rho g. P1 is equals to capital H plus small h into rho g. So that is. It, this is based on Boyle's law. How it is Boyle's law? So that means we know PV is equals to constant, pressure into volume can be written as area into length, that is equals to constant, PL is equals to constant. That means P1 L1 is equals to P2 L2 is equals to P3 L3 and so on. That is Boyle's law. So this is the fill tube. This total area of cross section remains constant. But what is the quantity changes here? Length of the air column trapped. Length of the air column trapped must be changes in different situations. So that's why we can write pressure into length remains constant. Pressure into length remains constant. Here the concept. Here first condition is open end is acting, open end is upwards. First one is, first application, open end is upwards. If the open end is upwards like this, so that is pressure equals to force per unit area, force equals to pressure into area. Based on this, total upward force equals to total downward force. So this is the fill tube, and here a mercury column is trapped. Here mercury column is trapped like this. Now in this situation, let L1 is the length of the air column. Here L1 is the length of the air column. So now here it is, total upward force equals to total downward force. We know force can be written as pressure into area. Force can be written as pressure into area. So now here F1, let us say upward, downward force, weight of the mercury column always acting downwards, Mg. Next plus F2, F2 is downwards. That pressure due to, force due to this pressure, force due to this pressure. So this is the cap. P1 can be written as capital H plus small h rho g. Capital H is, capital H is height of mercury column, height of mercury column in barometer, atmospheric pressure, height of the mercury column in barometer. That is the situation. So this is open end upwards, first case only. If the open end of the tube is upwards. Now next case, second condition, here open end is downwards like this. This is L2 second case. Open end is up downwards. Let us say here it is P0 and here it is P1. Here weight of the mercury column acting downwards. Second condition, open end is downward. Open end is downwards like this. That means the quill tube is reversed. In this situation, what happens? So this is the pressure of the enclosed air column. This is called pressure of the enclosed air column. This is the closed and this is the mercury column. So that is here in this situation, certain amount of air is trapped. That is called pressure of the enclosed air column. So that is L2 and it is P0. Small h is, we know, height of the or length of the mercury column in quill tube, let us say. So total upward force equals to total downward force. Total upward force due to this pressure, the force acting upwards. Due to this pressure, the force acting downwards, and mg also acting downwards. Total upward force, let us say F2, that is equals to F1 plus mg. F2 means P0A, F1, P1A plus mg. So let us say it is P2, second case. So from this, P2A is equals to P0A minus mg. So let us say it is P2, second pressure, second case. In the first case, that is P1. Yes. So P2A is equals to P0A minus volume into density into g. P0A minus volume can be AH rho g. So that is P2A. Area cancels on both sides. So P2 can be written as capital H rho g minus small h rho g. So P2 is equals to capital H minus small h into rho g. If the open end of the tube is acting downwards, the pressure can be written as capital H minus small h into rho g, capital H minus small h into rho g. That is the situation. See, here we know P naught, P is equals to force per area, force, okay, you know. Here the total upward force equals to total downward force, that is important. So due to this pressure, the force acting upwards, but due to this pressure, the force acting downwards. And weight of the liquid or weight of the mercury column also acting downwards. So that means P2A is equals to P0A minus mg. So from this, P2 is equals to capital H minus small h into rho g. P2 is equals to capital H minus small h into rho g. So that is the situation now. P2 this is. Next third situation it is. Third case is, if the tube is placed along horizontal direction like this. If the quill tube is placed like this. This is the mercury column. So like this, So let us say it is P3, it is always P0. Here downward force, weight due to this is mg downwards. But here the force due to this pressure is in this direction, the force due to this pressure is in this direction. Due to pressures the forces are in opposite direction, but weight is mg here. Weight does not include here. See here, P3 equals to P0. Now force due to P3 is equals to here force due to P0, because both are in opposite direction, that's why those two forces must be equal. So that means P3A is equals to P0A. AA gets cancelled, P3 is equals to just capital H rho g. Here the length of the air column is L3. Length of the air column is L3. So P3 is equals to H rho g. So three conditions here. One, first condition is open end is acting upwards, open end is acting downwards. Next, the quill tube is along horizontal direction. Next, fourth condition is just here we are equating the forces, opposite forces must be equal. Force due to P3 must be equal to force due to P0. Pressure can be written as H rho g, atmospheric pressure, P equals to H rho g. So next, for example, next situation, fourth situation, if the quill tube is arranged like this, so let us say this is the mercury column. So let us say it is length of the L4, it is, so it is P4 and it is again P0 and it is mg. So let us say it makes an angle theta here, this is 90, this is 90 minus theta, 90 minus theta. So here this can be written as, this is 90 minus theta, mg can be divided into two components, weight mg can be divided into two components. So this is based on resolution of vectors, so here I am considering the angle theta. So this is 90, here it is 90 minus theta, mg can be divided into, again this is theta, so this becomes mg cos theta and this is mg sin theta, mg cos theta, mg sin theta. That is based on resolution of vectors. In vectors chapter you can get clarity about this. So this is mg cos theta and this is mg sin theta. Now opposite forces we can equate. So in this direction the force is, so let us say force due to P4, is equals to force due to P0 plus mg sin theta, because this mg sin theta also acting downwards here. So this is the down the plane. So that's why force due to P4, P4A is equals to P0A plus mg sin theta. So that means, so P4A is equals to P0A plus, mass can be written as volume into density, that is AH rho g sin theta. Area cross section cancels on both sides. P4 is equals to P0 is H rho g plus small h rho g sin theta. So P4 is equals to capital H plus small h sin theta into rho g. P4 is equals to capital H plus small h sin theta into rho g. So this is the concept P4. So we calculated four types of pressures. Here the length of the liquid column is L4. Weight of the mercury column Mg acting downwards. Here the weight can be divided into two mutually perpendicular components, mainly that is based on resolution of vectors. So that is, this becomes Mg sin theta and this becomes Mg cos theta. So P0 and Mg sin theta acting down the plane and P4 acting up the plane. That's why force due to P4 is equals to force due to P0 and like this. So these are the four conditions here. If here I am considering angle theta here, that's why you got sin theta. If the angle is considered here it is theta is considered, then here we got cos theta. Here I am considering angle is theta, that's why I am getting sin theta here. If I consider theta here, if I consider theta here, here we got cos theta. So that is a where with what the angle is measured. So that is important. So now four conditions we got, that is, so we got P1 is equals to capital H plus small h into rho g, and P2 is equals to capital H minus small h into rho g, P3 is equals to capital H rho g, and P4 is equals to capital H plus small h sin theta into rho g. So these are the four type of pressures we got here. So according to Boyle's law, we are writing P1 L1 is equals to P2 L2 is equals to P3 L3, that is equals to P4 L4, and so on. So first I am equating these two. Let us say P1 L1 is equals to P2 L2. So if P1 L1, capital H plus small h rho g is equals to capital H minus small h, capital H plus rho g into L1 is equals to capital H minus small h into rho g L2. Rho g gets cancelled on both sides. So capital H L1 plus small h L1 is equals to capital H L2 minus small h L2. So based on this, this H L1 plus H L2 is equals to capital H L2 minus capital H L1. So H common, L1 plus L2 is equals to capital H common L2 minus L1. So small h is equals to capital H into L2 minus L1 by L1 plus L2. Based on this, we can calculate length of the mercury column in Kiltube. Length of the mercury column in Kiltube. Just P1 L1 is equals to P2 L2. P1 is capital H plus H rho g into L1, capital H minus small h rho g L2. So based on this, we calculate H L1 plus H L1. So like this, this H L2 comes to this side and this H L1 comes to this side based on this. So for example, if we vacate these two, P2 L2 is equals to, let us say, P3 L3. P2 means capital H minus small h rho g into L2 is equals to H rho g into L3. Capital H L2 minus small h L2 is equals to capital H L3. H L2 minus H L3 is equals to H L2. Small h is equals to capital H into L2 minus L3 by L2. In terms of L2, this is in terms of L1 L2. This is in terms of L1 L2. And this is in terms of L2 L3. By equating these two or any two, we can get the value of the height of the liquid, height or length of the mercury column in Kiltube. Length of the mercury column in Kiltube. What is capital H? Height of the liquid column in barometer. That is atmosphere 76 centimeters of Hg. Approximately, always the capital H value is 76 centimeters of Hg. So this is Kiltube apparatus. Based on this, we can calculate height of the or length of the mercury column in Kiltube by using L1 L2 or L2 L3 or L1 L4, any two. If you know any two lengths, we can calculate this one. next. Next application based on this is let us say it is the piston up to here. Let capital V. So, the capital V is the total volume now. In this situation, V is the total volume. If the piston is fixed here, if the piston is fixed, then total volume of the container is capital V. Now, if the piston moves outwards, that means stroke volume it is, strokes, number of strokes. So, stroke means if the piston is moves outwards and released, if the piston pulled out and released, then what happens? Certain amount of volume increases, so that the pressure decreases. Initially, V is the volume, P total volume, and P naught is the initial pressure. V is the initial total volume and P naught is the initial pressure. So, according to Boyle's law, P naught V naught is equals to, let us say it is also V naught, initial volume it is V naught. Now, first situation, if the piston, this is the mobile piston, if the piston moves out and released, pulled out, if the piston is pulled out and released, then what happens? Volume increases. Volume increases. So, that is, let us say V. Now, from Boyle's law, so P naught V naught is equals to, we can write it as P1 V1. According to Boyle's law, P naught V naught is equals to P1 V1. So, let us say it is P naught V naught, P1 into V1 is V plus V naught plus V. So, volume increases. If the piston is moves outwards to this position, so let us say it is the small volume V. Now, the total volume is V naught plus V. If the piston is pulled out, so let us say V is the volume increased. So, the total volume is V naught plus V. So, from this P1 can be written as P naught into V naught by V naught plus V. P1 is equals to P naught into V naught by V naught plus V. This is the pressure at this position. This is the pressure after first stroke. First stroke means piston pulled out and released. That is the first stroke. So, P1 is equals to P naught into V naught by V naught plus V. That is the first stroke. For next stroke, for second stroke, for second stroke, for second stroke means second time the piston is moves out. Again from Boyle's law, so let us say P1 V1 is equals to P1 V0 is equals to P2 V2. So, if the stroke piston pulls out and released, again it reaches to the same position. So, that is why again it reaches to the same position, but the pressure changes to P1. See here, initial pressure is P0, initial volume is V0. If the piston pulled out and released, slowly again the piston reaches to the same position. For example, if the syringe is pulled down and released, slowly the syringe moves outwards and it reaches to initial position like that. So, P1 is equals to P0 into V0 by V0 plus V. This is the first pressure. For the second stroke, in the second condition, what is the pressure in that situation? P1. But the volume is again V naught. P1 V naught is equals to P2 into V2 can be written as again volume changes.
V naught by V naught plus V. So from this P2 is equals to V naught. So V naught gets cancelled. So here P1 is equals to again. So same pressure. It is sorry. So again V2 is only V0 plus V, volume increases. So P1 V0 is equals to P2 into V2, P1 V0 equals to P2 into volume must be increases, again V0. So from this P2 is equals to P0 into V0 by V0 plus V, sorry P1, P2 is equals to P1 into V0 by V0 plus V. So therefore we can write P2 is equals to, in place of P1 what we can write? P0 into V0 by V0 plus V into V0 by V0 plus V. So therefore P2 is equals to P0 into V0 plus V whole square. For the second stroke it is V0 by V0 plus V whole square. So for the first stroke P0 V0 equals to P1 V1, due to the increase in volume pressure must be decreases. So what is the first case? The pressure P0 into V0 by V0 plus V. So this is till now no doubt, that is according to Boyle's law, temperature remains constant. But for the second stroke, after a certain time again it reaches to the same position, again we are applying the second stroke. Of course, its volume reaches to same position, the pressure in that situation is P0, sorry P1, the pressure in that situation is P1. Second stroke, P1 V0 is equals to P2 V2, again V2, V0 plus V. That's why by using number of strokes, the pressure must be decreases. How the pressure of the system decreases? By the stroke volume. If the number of strokes happens, the pressure decreases and so on. After n strokes, it is Pn is equals to P0 into V0 by V0 plus V whole to the power of n. For n strokes, how much amount of pressure must be decreases? For n strokes, how much amount of pressure must be decreases? That is P0 into V0 by V0 plus V whole power n. P0 into V0 by V0 plus V whole power n. So this is the strokes volume. So that means due to increase in volume, pressure must be decreases. So that means without changing the volume of the vessel here, the pressure must be decreases by using the strokes. For first stroke, the pressure decreases to this much. For the second stroke, the pressure decreases to this much. After n strokes, that is pressure. Where P0 is initial pressure, like this. These are the two applications of Boyle's law. Now two more applications. This so next class we can start the chapter calorimetry means specific heat, latent heat, everything it is. Next day we can start that chapter. So that is expansion of gases completed.